Hello everybody, and welcome to my long-awaited wing tutorial. So a lot of you guys have been wondering how I made my wings, and you asked for a tutorial. So, I am providing that for you right now, and I'm letting my hot glue gun heat up. If I have enough glue, I will see if I can finish this on April 5th of 2024. Today, it is 9:30 in the morning. I am going to be working on this all day. If I finish today, I'll have it up and posted this evening. But if I don't, I'm sorry, I'm out of glue. So, I will do my best. But, here's your material list. Here's the things you're gonna need. If you're doing feathered wings, I suggest getting the colors of feathers you need. I get 12 inch at least for the flight feathers, and then I get smaller feathers. About medium size, 10 to 8 inch feathers. And then I get 6 to 4 inch feathers for the inside. You'll definitely need a lot of hot glue. A lot of hot glue. You're gonna need foam or fabric to put on these screws, like the hinges to cover the screws. The reason behind this is because sometimes wings like this, the screws in the nut that's holding it together, they fall out. Alrighty, let's get started. So, first thing, you're gonna take your big feathers and go around the outside edge of the wings. Start with one wing first. You're gonna take the big feathers, lay them backside down, covering as much fabric as you can. It's okay if you can't cover it. Again, make sure you have an even number of feathers laid out in the size you need. So I'm gonna do black first, and then it's gonna fade to white, and then fade to orange, yellow to orange to red. So I have a box of feathers here. This is all you're gonna need. So I am starting with the larger black feathers and then going on with smaller ones. So as you see here, I just glued on the three big black feathers that were supposed to be on the edge of the wing. Sorry about that. Then I set the other three aside because they're gonna go on that wing. So what you're gonna do now is you're gonna line the outside wing with the colors you need. I'm out of white, so the edge is gonna be black, fading into red or orange, which is gonna look neat. I really genuinely hope these won't be ugly because I am currently gluing on the second layer as I speak right now, and they are not looking too good. But you can see me gluing on some of these feathers, and I'm holding them down, waiting for them to completely dry. So I was halfway through gluing the feathers on, and I noticed I'm out of hot glue. Yeah, I don't have any more sticks. Actually wait, I'm not out of glue. Joke's on myself, my grandmother gave me a bunch of her old stuff for sewing and stuff, and that includes a mini hot glue gun. Let me just get all this stuff out of the way. This is all sewing stuff. Baby hot glue gun.
Glue.
These are my big guns, and it'll take a minute for it to, take a minute for it to cool down. Even touching it is kind of too warm. So I'm gonna put that there and let it relax. I'm gonna let this one warm up. This is a baby hot glue gun. It looks so cute. I did a little work off camera. Just a little bit of work off camera. So I am in very limited supply of feathers. And I've also noticed that goose is not the most fursuit friendly design ever. So I had to buy a lot of feathers in a lot of different colors, and they still weren't enough. So I don't really have the money to buy more, so I'm just using what I have. When a character comes to being fursuit friendly, it all depends on the design. Alrighty. So, I've got the first layer of feathers glued onto the wing. Now, you can either continue the rest of this wing, or you can do it symmetrically on this side. It's up to you, but my personal preference is doing this side. Now, I'm not going to be filming the other wing on camera, because you already watched me do that side. I'm gonna do that one off camera. So I will see you when this is done. Okay, you guys, this wing is feathered. So the next step is to do the second row. So really quick, a little disclaimer, I meant to put this at the beginning of the video, but I didn't. When you glue feathers on these wings, they will be heavier. There's no way around it. They're gonna get heavy and they're gonna get difficult to open. And you also go from bottom to top with the feathers, that way they look natural. Because if you did top to bottom, then the ends of the feathers will be exposed. Let's get back into it. By the way, I apologize if my camera cuts out at any point. My storage is on the brink of being full, so. Little fun fact. Boosa's design is inspired by a Baltimore Oriole, a Blue Jay, and a Palace Cat. Some of you might be wondering, what is a Palace Cat? Well, they are a small wild cat that live in the mountains of Mongolia, Syria, and Russia. So this wing is okay. I'm out of blue feathers, so it kind of looks gross, but I'm in the middle of gluing these ones. I'm using purple feathers because I don't really have anything else to use, but I'll get back to you when this row's done. Okay, so the third layer of the feathers is done on this wing. Time for that one. This is gonna be super fun. The amount of times I've had to root through those bags of feathers to find purple ones and red ones. Oh my lord. All right guys, so I've got to take a break because it is lunchtime and I am hungry. So I will continue this when I am back from lunch. So I will see you then. If I finish today, I will post the wing tutorial this evening. If not, dogs! Stop! If I finish by the end, stop! Girls, do you need to go outside? Come on, doll. Come on, Millie. No? Okay. If I finish, if you're doing feathered wings, I would suggest, well, this is the whole tutorial.
Oh, I did not have enough time lapse.
Oops, ow. Hey everybody, it is almost 4:00. I am so sorry I have not been back here. I went out to eat and I took a little bit of a break. And I did not mean for it to be 3 hours long, so I am about to get back to work. So I am currently gluing on the third layer on the right wing. So I'm almost done with that if I have enough purple feathers. And if I don't, then that's gonna be an issue. Man, I am struggling to find purple feathers. I was rooting through those boxes, trying to find the colors I needed. Make sure you have the colors you need before you start something like this. Please. It is so tedious. I am nearly out of purple feathers and I'm so upset. Because I have none left. Barely any, they're all broken, they're all in here. And the only purple feathers left in here, the only purple feathers left in here are the big ones, and I'm saving. But I sure do have a surplus of green feathers. If any of you guys watching need some green feathers, hit me up, because I've got a surplus.
It's time to finally give these two a home. So this one, it's going on one on each wing. So that's going there, that one's going there. So this one's gonna go up here, and then I've got these, a handful of blue. There's more in here, but they're all broken, and I'm gonna have to use them in two places, because there's this row that I'm gonna do, don't have white, so I'm gonna skip to yellow, orange if I have enough, can't do black, because I don't have any black feathers, that, can't do white, can't do black, orange, if I have enough. I cannot stress this enough. Make sure you have enough of what you need before you start a project.
Don't make my mistake. Trust me. Please. I don't want you to be miserable. I really do not want you to be miserable with this. I can't buy any more feathers right now because of money issues, but, yeah. Make sure you have what you need.
So this layer, for the blue layer, I'm just gonna stagger the small blue feathers. That way I give myself some grace with the room, and that way I can save materials and go back later on when I go to add more stuff.
I require sacrifice. I am so sorry. Ugh. I'm gonna find blue feathers that aren't visible otherwise on Goose's wings that I can take out of the front to put on the back, because I can't take it.
I'm not necessarily the proudest person after doing that. Forgive me, wings, I'm sorry.
And forgive me, viewers. They weren't really visible on our wings anyways, so I might as well have just redone it. Don't do that, by the way. Unless they're not visible and you need feathers, be careful which ones you pull out, because some of them are necessary, some of them are just there. Be careful, that's all I have to say.
So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the blue feathers that I removed from the front and stagger them, window them with the little blue ones, so that way I'm not wasting material.
It's now 5. I am wasting so much time trying to salvage feathers. I have so many green feathers. Anyway, yeah. Hopefully, like 3 more rows to go if I have enough. If I don't have enough, I apologize. I really don't know what I'm gonna do if I don't have enough feathers. But, I'm not gonna film the, next few steps until it's the last step, because my phone storage is almost full and I don't really want to fill it up with like footage. That and I'm kind of tired of having to stop recording and then go back, edit, start recording, go back, stop it. You get the gist. So I will be right back, and hopefully it'll be less than an hour. So it is about 20 after 5. I am out of feathers. Black, orange, and yellow. Orange I need, but I have 2 for each wing. Black I need, but I have 3 for each wing. Yellow I need, but I have 2 for each wing. So either I'm gonna have to rip out feathers out of Goose in the front, or I will have to postpone. I might have to just pull feathers from the front. I think that'd be a better option. I am tired, y'all. I'm really sorry. I'm gonna just take a short break, not a 3-hour one, like maybe 30 minutes-ish, just to clear my mind. I'm gonna pull some feathers and get back started.
So this is what I mean by the wings get difficult to open over time. So wings are perfectly aligned in the back for this. Look at how much force I need to open these wings. Look at how far my arms need to move outward in order to get these to be raised.
Check this out. Like,
so, they look okay. This wing, I have to pull these strings. Like, I'm surprised they're not fraying, kind of difficult to open. They open when I like move my body around like this, or if I spin, they open by themselves, like hands out, I open, they open already due to like force. But I had an idea. So the screws, the tighter they are, the less
force is needed to open that. If I loosen these screws, would it put less force on the wings to have them open? It's an idea. But it's not what I'm going to do right now, because I need to get the feathers on these completely before I do any more adjustments. Ugh, lordy, lordy, lordy. But yeah, they look really ugly from the back. Like this front, gorgeous, beautiful. And then you have the back. What is that? It is so bad. Because I'm out of feathers. Oh, it's killing my back. I'm so glad I'm getting those angel wings next week on Wednesday. So, yeah, and they fold fine, but they shed. That's another issue. They shed a lot. So you have to expect that when you make feathered mechanical wings.
Hey guys. Sorry that cut out. Just letting you guys know, I'm going to be posting a part 2 to this video because I am not going to continue the wings today. Because I'm getting a migraine and I'm very tired. And my parents won't like it if I keep hot gluing. So, I'm also going to see if I can buy more feathers when I get money. So it's going to be postponed until then. But I think you guys get the gist and you can go from there. Basically, is when you get to the end, you're going to put a little bit of, like, a light lycra or something, and then, or something. I don't know. I haven't done that yet. Just put something that covers the rest of the, like, ends of the feathers. Maybe, like, a feather boa or something. Like a Mardi Gras boa or something. That's an idea. So, I'd suggest that. Give that a try. I'm sorry about not being able to film. My phone doesn't like me. I will see you guys in the next one. I'm sorry. Have a great night or day, wherever you are. Bye!
Oh, I can't take it. There we go. The hot glue smell is rampant in my house, and it's so strong, and I hate the smell. I'm gonna make my house smell like cookies. I'm gonna light like 3 candles. And it's too much for my brain. I'm getting a migraine. There are also feather particles everywhere, so I'm gonna vacuum for the second time today.